Everybody, welcome to our live lesson. Sorry, we're a few minutes late starting today, but I can see lots of you already joining us in the chat and saying hello. So that's brilliant. So my name's Jo. I'm your teacher today and I'm in France. So what about you? Where are you joining us from today? Let us know. Say hi in the chat and tell me where you are, where you're joining us from. I've already seen people from France, Barcelona, Armenia. So if there's more countries, which I'm sure there are, let me know. Tell me in the chat where you are. So hello, Digby. Hi, welcome back to you there in Sri Lanka. Hi there in Barcelona, Mallorca. Hi, Carlos. Arthur in Armenia. Hello. Hi there in Chennai. Hello. I've seen Yuli also. Hi there in Hong Kong. Hi from Kiev. Hello to you. Algeria, Milan, Italy, I can see. Argentina. Okay, so as usual, we've got lots and lots of different countries. Bucharest, Romania. Lovely to see you all. So as usual, join in as much as you can in the chat today. Qatar, Colombia. Okay, lots of people. While people are still joining, maybe we can have a look in a little bit more detail at what we're going to be doing in today's session. So we're going to start with a little introduction to our topic today, which is contrasting ideas. So a contrast, that's when there's a big difference that we can see between two things. So that's our introduction. Then we're going to look at some grammar, which today is using conjunctions for contrasting your ideas. Then we'll have a quiz to see how much you remember, and then it will be your turn to practice. Okay, so I can see a few more people have joined us in the meantime. Lolly from France, same as me. Hi, Italy, Turkey, Algeria, London. Okay, fantastic to have you all with us today. Okay, so in a minute, we're going to have an introduction and we're going to show you some pictures. And I'd like to know your opinions about these things. So you're going to have a look at some pictures and tell me what you think about them. Okay, so just waiting for maybe for a few more people to join before we have a look at those pictures. Hi there in Brazil. Lots and lots of countries here today. I've seen Spain, Sri Lanka, Mexico, lots of places. Okay, so here's our first picture. So let me know, what can you see on the picture and what do you think about it? What's your opinion about this? What do you think? What's your opinion about this thing that you can see in the picture? So little clue, I said that I'm in France and I've seen some other people in the comments are in France too. So is this very famous thing? What do you think about it? What is it and what do you think about it? Okay, so somebody's got it. Lolly, yes, of course, it's the Eiffel Tower. And I can see a few other people have got that too. What do you think? What do you think about this place? Lesvia says, great architecture and history. Yeah, okay, I agree with you there. What are your opinions about it? So lots of people have said that it's the Eiffel Tower. What are your opinions about this? Okay, because a lot of people, have you actually been there? Have you seen it? Or have you just seen, have you maybe seen it in videos or in pictures? What's your opinion? Okay, so human is creative, right? So human beings are creative, right? Because it was made by Gustav Eiffel. That's why it's called the Eiffel Tower. It's iconic, says Katia. Yes, excellent. Okay, so people are saying it's in Paris. Very impressive. That's your opinion. Okay, good. It's Juan Gabriel, I remember my last trip. Did you go up to the top? Did you go to see it? What's your opinion of it? So big and tall, that's a masterpiece. Okay, good word there, masterpiece. Dipthy, great engineering effort. Absolutely, yes. Okay, so we can see that many tourists go there. It's marvelous, it's famous, it's unusual, definitely a historical landmark. Okay, so some different opinions there. It's a historical landmark in France. Okay, great. So it's been good to read your opinions about this this place or this thing. We've got some more pictures for you to give us your opinions on. Okay, so this one's a little bit different. What can you see here in the picture? Not just the animal, but where is the animal? Look in the background and tell me, what's your opinion of this place or a place like this? Okay, what are your opinions about this? So we can see an animal, and where is the animal? Is it in the wild or something else? And what's your opinion about this? Okay, so in the meantime, lots of people have good opinions about the Eiffel Tower. Okay, so Lucia says, it's in a zoo. Yes, exactly, Lucia. What's your opinion of zoos? Do you like them? Or have you got a different opinion about zoos? What do you think? Okay, some people have different opinions about seeing animals in captivity in a place like this. What do you think? Okay, Deepthi says that she visited France in and the Eiffel Tower. Okay, excellent. Okay, what's your opinions? So people are saying a zoo is for animals, right? Okay, so it's for animals and it's for people. Human beings go to zoos to see animals. What do you think of that idea? What do you think of the idea of going to see an animal is in an animal in the zoo? Okay, so animals in the zoo. The zoo is interesting for people, but it's a lack of freedom for the animals. Right, exactly. So there we've got two different kinds of ideas. Katia, in the zoo, but I disagree with its presence in the zoo. Okay, so Katia, your opinion is you're not really in favor of zoos. Okay, Francesco, sincerely, I don't like the zoo, or I don't like zoos. I like visiting the zoo, especially with my kids. Okay, so we've got some different opinions here now. Okay, so some people like visiting zoos and some people don't. Okay, so different things here. Wild animal in the zoo, it's not my cup of tea, right? So it's not really something that you like. Somebody's saying in the zoo we can learn about the nature of animals. Okay, so some people think it's a place to learn about animals, and some people think that it's more like a prison for animals, I've been reading. So in the zoo, we can learn about the nature of animals. Okay, so some different opinions there about zoos. Shall we move on? We've got another picture for you. This one's a bit different again. What can you see on this picture? What can you see? And what's your opinion about this? Okay, so I'm still reading some zoo comments while you're telling me your opinion about this next picture. Zoos are important for children to see and learn. I don't like zoos as the animals are not in their natural habitat. Okay, so lots of different opinions about zoos. What about this one? Okay, so people are saying it's a pizza, it's Italian food. What topping can you see on it? What kind of pizza is it? Yuli says it's appetizing. Okay, a slice of pizza. What do you think about the topping of the pizza? Aline says this is a pineapple pizza. Yes, Aline. Lolly, pizza, it makes me hungry. Right. Okay, so that's what you think. Do you like the topping that you can see on this pizza? Bruno says it's not healthy food. Right. Okay. So pizza is, yeah, it's fast food. Maybe it's something we shouldn't eat every day. But what about, what can we see on there? I can see ham, and other people have got it. Raphael, pineapple pizza. Yeah, do you like pineapple on pizza? Is that one of your favorite toppings? Some people say delicious. Deepfi says, I think there's pineapple and bacon. Right, do you like pineapple and bacon? Have you tried pineapple on pizza? Do you think it's a good combination of toppings? What do you think? So Bruna says, I hate it. Katia says, pizza is my favorite food. I can't live without it. And it's an Italian symbol. Yeah, we've had a symbol of France with the Eiffel Tower. Now we've got a symbol of Italy with the pizza. Okay, somebody's saying it's my favorite. Okay, coming back to zoos, keeping animals in zoos has both advantages and disadvantages. Yeah, okay, so there we've got again two different opinions. Natasha says, yes, I love mixing ingredients. So the ham or the bacon and the pineapple, you think that goes well together? Okay. Looks like pineapple pizza, but not too Italian, right? So maybe this is something that's not like an authentic, original Italian recipe for a pizza. Lucia, are you Italian maybe? Because you're telling us that the true Italian pizza is made of tomatoes and mozzarella. Okay, so some people say we shouldn't be putting pineapple on pizza. Anna, no, I'm not a big fan of pineapple on pizza. Right. Okay, so we've got some different opinions about this pizza topping and about pizzas in general. Okay, let's have a look at another picture. In the meantime, pizza's not favorite, but it's not so healthy. Okay, now this picture. Now, I've got to explain this one a little bit. Pineapple pizza is as weird as broccoli ice cream. I like that comment, girlfriend. Thank you. So, this picture doesn't quite look real to me. It looks like it could have been generated by artificial intelligence. So, that's what we're looking at here. It's not the fact that it looks like an igloo, but just that the fact that this picture has been made, it's been generated by artificial intelligence. It's not a real photo. It's not a real picture. So, what do you think about artificial intelligence? What's your opinion about that? Do you think it's good that we can make pictures of anything that don't really exist? Or what's your opinion? Okay, lots of people have got ideas of what it is. It's a romantic date house, it's a wedding house, an igloo, an ice hut. The picture looks like a haunted house. It's very good. So people like this picture. It actually does look like a cool kind of place, doesn't it? It's like an inn or from a fairy tale. It's beautiful, similar to an igloo. Okay, so these are all your opinions about this place. Partially good, okay, makes a peaceful life. So it sounds like people that your opinions mainly are that you like the picture. So I think everybody's mainly got the same opinion there, but it's been made by artificial intelligence. So what do you think of the fact that it's not a real picture? It's good, but we should use it for good work. Okay, Janica, that's your opinion about artificial intelligence. Right. Okay. Somebody's got a great comment. Oh, it's use AI is useful but dangerous too. Okay, so two opinions there. It's a double-edged sword, somebody said. That's a great expression. Said, AI, artificial intelligence, is great in so many ways and it can help us to showcase our imaginations. Right, so maybe like this picture, this is maybe somebody's imagination put into a picture. Okay, Raphael, great expression. AI is a double-edged sword. So, yeah, two different sides to it. Deepthi says AI has got good and bad about it. Alexandra, artificial intelligence can change the view of th things, but it's obvious that it's artificial and it doesn't have a soul somehow. Okay, yeah, really good comment there. Thank you. I like that. AI has taken over human work and creativity. Right, and we're going to talk about AI a little bit more later on in the lesson. So keep all of your great ideas about AI. Being able to use AI successfully is like having a magic wand. Right, yes, okay, excellent. Okay, so people, some are saying it's an amazing tool. Others are saying we have to use it for good things. Okay, last picture now. What can we see here in the picture? And what's your opinion about this? So we've had lots of opinions. We've already had opinions about the Eiffel Tower, pizza, zoos, artificial intelligence. And good question. Hi, I'm from Somalia. And what is the topic for discussion here? What we're discussing is contrasting opinions. So when people have got different opinions about the same thing, really opinions with like obvious differences. So AI is great or AI is dangerous. They're contrasting opinions. So what can we see? What are your opinions about this? Okay, it's a cruise on the river. Exactly. So we can see a really big ship that we call a cruise ship, and looks to me like a kind of a sort of historic village or something that we can see. I see a cruise ship. We have to put it that way around. It's a cruise ship on the river. I'm not sure actually where it is, but it looks like a beautiful place. Yeah, a cruise ship on the river. So what's your opinion? Have you ever been on a cruise? Would you like to? Diana, hi. So Anna, it's a dream, but I can't afford it. Yeah, okay, so I'm sure they're very expensive. I've never been on a cruise myself and I couldn't afford it either. So this is a town with a harbour. Yeah, a cruise ship in the ocean, good for a family trip together. Okay, does everybody agree or has anybody got a contrasting opinion about this? Okay, Lolly says cruises equal pollution. Right, okay, so that could be a disadvantage with a cruise. Francesco, it's not the right place for a cruise ship. Yeah, so maybe this this town or village we can see is too small to have all of those visitors and such a big ship coming into it. Carmen, hi, hello, how are you? Okay, so have you got any other opinions about this cruise ship? So some people say it looks great if I could afford it. Other people say it causes pollution. Okay, can you explain to me how to use though in different contexts? Especially, I don't understand it when it's used at the end of a sentence. Well, keep watching because that is exactly what we're going to be looking at in just a few minutes' time. We've been looking here at contrasting ideas. And we're going to look in more detail at words like though in just a minute. Luigi, that ship is contrasting with the landscape. Good point. Absolutely, I agree. Okay, so we've had a look at quite a few different things, places that could give us different people or just the same person contrasting opinions. So maybe shall we just recap what they were? They were the Eiffel Tower, a zoo, pineapple on pizza, artificial intelligence, and a cruise ship. Okay, so we've seen that just from your comments in the chat that we can have contrasting opinions about anything. Could be serious issues like a zoo or just something, you know, like a pineapple on pizza, something that doesn't really matter. But we can have contrasting opinions about everything. So let's have a look in a little bit more detail about how we can describe these contrasting contrasting opinions about things. Okay, so we're going to look now. Let's go back to the Eiffel Tower, and we're going to look at this one in a bit more detail to start with. So I'd like you now to look at this beginning of the sentence and match it to either A, B, C, or D. Which one is the contrasting opinion, the contrasting idea, the idea that's really different? So it starts off like this. Although the Eiffel Tower is now one of the best loved landmarks in the world, dot, dot, dot. How can we best finish that to get a contrasting idea? Is it A, others view it as an architectural masterpiece? B, it attracts millions of visitors annually? C, its design was originally hated by many Parisians? Or D, it remains an iconic landmark over 130 years later? And I think I remember seeing all of those opinions earlier. Miranda says C, its design was originally hated by many Parisians. Okay, lots of people are saying C. I think everybody's saying C. Yuli also. Okay, C. So it's now one of the best loved landmarks in the world. So that's really your clue there, that we've got loved. And then in one of these, we've got the opposite, which is loved or hated. Okay, so its design was originally hated by many Parisians. So that's the correct answer, exactly, Alejandro. So we've got two contrasting ideas there in our sentence, which begins with although. By the way, is that true? It is, Raphael. Yes, it's a true story. It was absolutely hated, and there was a big long debates about whether Paris was going to keep the Eiffel Tower or not. It nearly got pulled down. Is this a live stream? Yes, it is, Ken. Okay, let's see. Let's go on to the next sentence about the Eiffel Tower. We're going to find out a little bit more about it. So, despite being intended as a temporary exhibit, and what can we put then, A, B, C, or D? Despite being intended as a temporary exhibit, others view it as an architectural masterpiece. It attracts millions of visitors annually. We know it's not C, we've already had that one. Or it remains an iconic landmark over 130 years later. So it was a temporary exhibit. It was made for the World Exhibition, which took place in 1889. So it was only supposed to be up and standing during this exhibition and then taken down again. But what? It remains an iconic landmark over 130 years later. Lesfia agrees. D. Eva, D. Okay, Lucia also says D. Right, so we've got lots of agreement there. So we've got the Yuli 2 says D. Contrasting ideas there, so a temporary exhibit. And what's the answer? Is it D? Let's have a look at that a bit later. We're going to do a few more and then we'll have a look. Okay, so three. Whereas some people view it as merely a tourist attraction, how can we contrast now? Which of these half sentences contrasts with three? Whereas some people view it as merely a tourist attraction, is it A, others view it as an architectural masterpiece? B, it attracts millions of visitors annually? Remember, we're looking for a contrasting idea. Yuli says B. Okay, so you're looking there at the millions of visitors. But have a look. Maybe there's something which we could say is more of a contrasting idea than that one. Others view it as an architectural masterpiece. So yeah, look carefully at the sentence. Whereas some people view it as merely a tourist attraction. Stefania says A. So lots of people are saying A for this one. Okay, agreement here with A. Shall we have a look at the last one and then we can check all of the answers. So number four, in spite of high entrance fees. So the entrance fee, that's the ticket that you have to buy to go up the tower. And I don't know how much it costs, but I think it costs quite a lot. So in spite of high entrance fees, A, others view it as an architectural masterpiece. B, it attracts millions of visitors annually. C, its design was already hate. We know that it's not C. Or D, it remains an iconic landmark, which is the contrasting idea here. So in spite of high entrance fees, what do you think? Lots of people say B for this one. It attracts millions of visitors annually. Lots of agreement with B. Okay, so we wouldn't probably expect lots of people because the tickets are so expensive, but it is an iconic landmark, so people are maybe prepared to spend all that money when they go to Paris. Okay, good. Lots and lots of people have said B. Let's just check now. I think that nearly everybody got everything right. So let's have a look at the whole paragraph. Although the Eiffel Tower is now one of the best loved landmarks in the world, its design was originally hated by many Parisians. True story. But despite being intended as a temporary exhibit, it remains an iconic landmark over 130 years later. So in red, you can see the contrasting ideas in the sentences. Whereas some people view it as merely a tourist attraction, others view it as an architectural masterpiece. In spite of high entrance fees, it attracts millions of visitors annually. So there we've got the contrasting ideas about the Eiffel Tower. So yeah, some people really hated it when it was first built because they thought it was too modern. What you taught, madam, that appears on screen, it makes it easier to learn. Okay, Nazia, I hope that means that this has helped you seeing it on screen. Okay, so there we've seen, although, despite, whereas, and in spite of. And these are all conjunctions or phrases that we use when we want to express contrasting ideas. So there we've looked at the Eiffel Tower, from controversy to icon. So the controversy was at the beginning, it was a lot of debate and people not agreeing, and then it's become an icon later. And everybody agrees, more or less, that it's an iconic symbol of France. So, okay, so we are going to have a look in a minute at although, despite, whereas, in spite of, and some other conjunctions and phrases or expressions that we can use for contrasting ideas. So just to remind you that when we say contrasting, so a contrast is like an obvious difference between two things. So that's what we're talking about. Okay, so let's have a look at that in a bit more detail. Conjunctions for contrasting ideas. Although, despite, even if, even though, in spite of, much as, though, whereas, and while are all used to link two contrasting ideas or show that one fact makes the other surprising. Okay, so these words are what we're using to show that link between the contrasting ideas. So conjunctions for contrasting ideas. They can all be used at the beginning or in the middle of the sentence. So these two are saying the same thing. In spite of high entrance fees, it attracts millions of visitors annually. Or it attracts millions of visitors annually in spite of high entrance fees. So in spite of can be put in two different places in the sentence and it does not change the meaning. The main difference between these conjunctions is that they're followed by different structures. And that's what we're going to look at now. So let's start off with in spite of and despite. So after in spite of and despite, we use a noun phrase or the ing form. So I'm going to ask you to try to finish these sentences. So remember, we need to use a noun phrase or the ing form. What could we put here? Number one, we arrived on time in spite of. Or the film was really successful despite. So remember, we've got to. We're linking contrasting ideas. So we arrived on time in spite of. What could we have there that makes it sort of seem surprising that we arrived on time? What could we put? And the film was really successful despite. Okay, Adriana, we arrived on time in spite of missing the bus. Okay, that is fantastic because we've got missing, we've got the ing form there. In spite of missing the bus. Okay, excellent. Any other ideas? The traffic jam. Great. Okay, so we arrived on time in spite of the traffic jam. Perfect. Stefania, in spite of the traffic. Great. Lots of people are saying traffic jam. Raphael, in spite of running out of time. Okay, good. Yes, that's also possible. Anything else? Carmen says, in spite of my old car. Good. In spite of heavy traffic, I can see. And Carmen also has a number two. The film was really successful despite the cast. Okay, yeah, so perhaps the actors weren't so good. It was a bad cast, but the plot was still good and the film was still good. Ken, number one, in spite of heavy traffic and in spite of lots of problems encountered, right? So maybe there were problems during the filming. Diana, despite its poor cast. Excellent. Okay, lots of good ideas. Let's maybe check. These were my ideas, similar to some of yours. We arrived on time in spite of missing the train, or the film was really successful despite bad reviews. So lots of possibilities, but the most important thing is either we want this ing form or a noun phrase. Despite the low budget, that's a good idea. Yeah, nice one, Rosanna. Okay, let's move on. So in spite of and despite are often followed by the fact that plus subject plus verb. So we hear this a lot, despite the fact that, in spite of the fact that. So we arrived on time in spite of the fact that we missed the train, or the film was really successful despite the fact that it had bad reviews. Okay, or somebody said, in spite of the fact that the storyline was really weak. Yeah, you've got it exactly. That's exactly how we use it, Golfem. Okay, so that's in spite of. And despite those two go together because we use them in exactly the same way. They're interchangeable. Okay, so although, though, and even though. So after although, though, and even though, we use a subject plus a verb. So again, let's have your ideas on how to finish these, how to give some contrasting ideas with these. So number one, although she can ski really well, Number two, I passed the exam though, And three, even though our team lost. So what do you think? What are your ideas? Okay, so although she can ski really well, she fall. Remember the S on she? He, she, it, S, she falls. Although she can ski really well, she falls down sometimes, maybe. Somebody else says she hurt her leg. Yes, although she can ski really well, she hurt her leg. Rima, she fell down. Okay. She didn't want to enter the competition. Right, okay, nice idea. She didn't win the race. Okay, so we've all got the contrasting ideas here. Okay, what about number two? I passed the exam though. What do you think? So we want something here, a contrasting idea, something that made us think, maybe I wouldn't pass. I passed the exam, though I hadn't learned the subject well. Okay, Diana, that's nice. Yeah, good one. Ola says I was very sick. Rima says it was tough. All good ideas. Yeah, I passed the exam, though I was very sick. And that's Rima's comment. Although it was difficult, though I didn't review, though I hadn't studied hard. Okay, so lots of good ideas here. Though I hadn't studied hard, and all of your ideas, good ideas here, are showing a contrast. Number three, even though our team lost, we are happy. Yeah, okay, so there's a good contrast there. Any other ideas for number three? Even though our team lost, what do you think? We had a good spirit. Yeah, maybe we could say we were in good spirits, meaning we were in a good mood. Yeah, good, Nicholas. So we played very well. Even though our team lost, we played very well. Okay, great ideas. Okay, what were my ideas for those? Although she can ski really well, it took her years to learn. I passed the exam, though I didn't study much. And even though our team lost, we still enjoyed the match. So they all mean the same thing. But even though is slightly stronger than although and though. But you could use any of those three sort of interchangeably, and that would be fine. Somebody asked a bit earlier on, what about putting like though at the end? So though can also go at the end of the second phrase. And this way of expressing contrasting ideas is the most common in spoken English. So it's more common than in written English. I passed the exam. I didn't study much though. So that's another way that we can use it, just by putting though at the end. Okay, so that's although, though, and even though. We've got a few more for you. Even if. So even if means whether or not, or no matter whether, and it's followed by a subject plus a verb. So what do you think of this? Even if you are an expert swimmer, you careful at this beach. What do you think we could put here? So even if you are an expert swimmer, you careful at this beach. Diana says would be. You would be careful. I think maybe we need a different modal verb. Carmen also says would be. Try a different modal verb. Must be. Yeah, I think that one sounds kind of better for giving a warning or advice. Yeah, you must be careful. I can think of another couple of possibilities. Should be, right? Okay, that's advice. Dipthi, yeah, you should be. You need to be, Alexandra. Yes, good. So this is all giving us advice. You should be careful. So we're contrasting an expert swimmer, but you have to be careful at this beach. You should be careful. Ought to be, you must be. Right, so these are all good ideas. Good, Vitaly. Yeah, you ought to be careful at this beach. So this is all for giving advice. I've put you should be, but all of those other ideas that we've just seen were fine as well. Okay, so that's we've had even if. There are lots and lots of these different conjunctions and expressions that we can use to contrast our ideas, and we've just got a few more for you.
Oops, sorry. Oops, sorry.
So the next one is going to be while, and we'll get that slide up in just a second. So when we want, we can also use while when we are contrasting ideas. And while there would also mean the kind of the same as although. So we're going to use that in the same kind of way. So while is most commonly used with time, but it can also be used to mean despite the fact that or although. So what do you think here? While I made a few mistakes in my English exam, I... So something to contrast here. So while I made a few mistakes in my English exam, I... So what could we expect to happen if you make mistakes in an exam? But, okay, I did great. Okay, yes, Elena, good. While I made a few mistakes in my English exam, I did great. I still got flying colours. That's a nice expression. If you get flying colours, that means you passed really well. Ola, I passed it. Yeah, Diana, I passed it. I pass, I managed to get a pass, I had a good mark, I got a good mark. Stefania writes it. You've all got it here. Exactly. This is how we contrast the ideas. I like this one deeply. I managed to scrape through and get a pass. So only just, but you got a pass. Okay, I think that was the same as the idea that I had. While I made a few mistakes in my English exam, Manuel, I passed with flying colours. Yeah, I put, I still passed. So I perhaps wasn't expecting to because I'd made a few mistakes, but I still passed. Okay, so that's while used instead of although, but we also use while and whereas. We can use these two together in the same way to mean but, or compared with the fact that, or to compare two contradictory ideas. So while, or whereas, Ivan is very sociable, his brother, how is he different? What do you think? What's the opposite of sociable? Or number two, my trip home was quick and easy, whereas, or while, my colleagues, What do you think? Somebody put just a very simple answer for number one. Paola says, while Ivan is very sociable, his brother is not. Yeah, perfect. So there, that's a complete contrast. any other ideas for number one or number two? where I can see is a real introvert. Exactly. So Ivan is sociable. He likes spending time with other people. Jonah says his brother is aloof. Okay. Yes. Okay. That's a good word to use. He's aloof. He doesn't make much contact with other people because maybe he thinks that he is above them. Elena is a real introvert. Some people saying is a bit shy. Is not a party animal. Great. Good answers here. His brother is an introvert and prefers to stay at home. Is reticent. Okay. What do you think about number two? Miranda says his brother is shy. My trip home was quick and easy, whereas my colleagues, what do you think? My colleagues was longer. Diana, I think you mean whereas my colleagues' journey or my colleagues' trip home was longer. So theirs was longer. Any other ideas for number two? My trip home was quick and easy, whereas my colleagues experienced many problems. Good idea, Alexandra. Whereas my colleagues, I can see stuck in traffic. Yeah. Whereas my colleague was a nightmare. Maybe had a nightmare. My colleagues had a nightmare getting home, you could say, something like that. My colleagues are still on their way home, right? My colleagues still on their way home, yep. Okay, so you've got the idea. We're contrasting. Ivan is very sociable, but his brother is very reserved. That means he's kind of shy, as some of you have said. And my trip home was quick and easy, whereas my colleagues got stuck in traffic. Again, we've got the contrast there. So in this sense, while or whereas can come at the beginning of the sentence or between the two contradictory clauses. So, oh, what's the meaning of trip home? Good question, Natasha. It just means your journey, the time that you took to travel from your work. I guess it's work here because we talk about the colleagues, the time going from work to home. So on the bus or on the in your car or whatever. Okay, I think we've just got one last one, much as. So we don't use this one as often because it's a more formal expression and it means although, despite how much, or no matter how much. Okay, so we're using it in the same way as although. So ideas for this one. Much as I enjoyed studying abroad, what's a contrasting idea that we can put there? Somebody's asking, what does reserved mean? It means shy. It means shy and somebody who doesn't really love having contact with other people. So much as I enjoyed studying abroad, what ideas have we got? Okay, I preferred studying in my homeland. I really missed my family. Okay, good. I experienced some culture shock, right? Okay, yes. There were some things that were not like how things are at home. I missed my family. Alexandra, the weather did not suit me. Okay, excellent ideas here. I was homesick. It was a very demanding experience. I liked coming home. I had homesickness, we have to say. Rosanna, I really miss my family. Yeah, Daniel, so you could say I was homesick or I had homesickness, one or the other. Okay, good. Good answers. I missed my home so much. Okay, good, Ken. So I think, yeah, my answer was probably the same as a lot of yours. Much as I enjoyed studying abroad, it was good to return home. Okay, so we've looked at lots of conjunctions and expressions to link contrasting ideas. And I think you all seem to have really got the right idea by reading your comments, which were all really great. So let's just do a little quiz now to check just exactly that we've understood everything correctly. So number one, I managed to finish the marathon in decent time. The last few kilometers were tough. Is it A, although, B, in spite of, or C, even? What do you think? Number one, A, although, B, in spite of, or C, even? I managed to finish the marathon in decent time. The last few kilometers were tough. Okay, B, in spite of. Now, look carefully. It's not in spite of the fact that. It's just in spite of. Deepathy says A, although. Diana says B. Okay, I can also see somebody saying C. So, well, we've got contrasting opinions here in our quiz. What does everybody think? Is it A, B, or C? So I'm seeing all lots of different answers here. Although, okay, so lots of people are saying A. Jonna, A, although. Okay, we've got a B there. Paula says A. Riyadh says B. Okay, so I think most people are either saying it's A or B. Okay, so just remember though, that let's have a look at what comes after. The last few kilometers were tough. Manuel says all of them are correct. No, only one. Sometimes I trick you like that, Manuel. You're right. I have tricked you like that in the past. But here, just one correct answer. Shall we have a look at it? Although, I managed to finish the marathon in decent time, although the last few kilometers were tough. Okay, so if we wanted to use in spite of there, we'd have to change the next part of the sentence a bit. We'd have to say in spite of the fact that the last few kilometers were tough, or in spite of the last few kilometers being tough. So that's why it's not in spite of, because of what follows in the sentence. And even, it would have to be even if the last few kilometers were tough, but we didn't have an if there. Okay, that one was quite difficult, I think. Let's have a look at number two. Let's see if this one's also a challenge. So, that I'm fluent in Spanish, I still get nervous if I have to give a presentation. Is it even though, despite the fact, or in spite of? So have a look carefully at what we've got. That I'm fluent in Spanish. That I'm fluent in Spanish. Only one of those is possible. Which one is it? Which one do you think? Yuli says B, despite the fact that. Okay, I think lots of people agree with that. Rima also says B. Stefania also says B. Yes, Vitali. Okay, more agreement here, although we've got a few A's. But we've got the fact that we've got this that here means there's only one correct answer. What is that correct answer? Shall we check it? Another B. Okay, despite the fact that I'm fluent in Spanish, we could say even though, but we couldn't have that, then we would just have to say, even though I'm fluent in Spanish. But because we've got that, despite the fact that, that all goes together as an expression, despite the fact that I'm fluent in Spanish. Okay, now number three, our last quiz question. My sister has four children. I struggle with taking care of two cats. So that's the difference. My sister, four children. I have two cats. What can we use there to link these two ideas? My sister has four children. A, despite. B, even. Or C, while. What do you think? Which one is the correct word there to link these two, the two phrases? Alexandra says C, yes. Okay, good. I can see B's and C's. Elena also says C. C says hun, while. Francesca says while. Diana also agrees it's while. Okay, so lots of correct answers. Lily also says while, Julia. Okay, so my sister has four children, while I struggle with cats and dogs. Okay, two cats or cats and dogs, which is the correct one? It's while, yeah. Okay, the other ones we would have to change the second phrase, like my sister's four children, despite the fact that I struggle, or even if I struggle with taking care, or even though I struggle taking care of two cats. So that's why it's while, because there we've got I struggle afterwards. Okay, so we've had a quiz. We've had lots and lots of information today. I think now it's your turn to practice using the conjunctions. So if you remember at the beginning, we had the Eiffel Tower, we had pineapple on pizzas, we had artificial intelligence. So what I'm going to ask you now is to tell me about pineapple on pizzas, to use as many of these conjunctions as you can, to tell me about like different opinions, contrasting opinions about pineapple on pizza. Okay, love it or hate it. So you've given me your opinions already. So let's have a look at a text and how we can complete it using these conjunctions. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you're enjoying the lesson. Oh, Carmen, thank you. I need more practice, no doubt. Yeah, also, if you want to have more practice with this, don't forget that we've got on the Learn English website, we've got lots more exercises and a whole explanation that you can look at. Okay, so in these little colored boxes, oh, I'm glad you love it. That's great news. Okay, so we can see lots of conjunctions here and a text. So can you complete the text using these conjunctions? Okay, so despite the fact that a lot of people love pizza, I hate it. Excellent. Okay. So some people adore pineapple on pizza, others detest it. Alexandra, although I love pizza, pineapple isn't for me. Great. Okay. How can we complete number one? Have you got an idea? Even though pineapple is not popular in our country, it's a tasty match with cheese on pizza. Nice, Ken. Great. Okay, so Natasha says, although as an option for number one, although some people adore pineapple on pizza, others detest it. Okay, lots of people have said, although. I can also see much as. Despite the fact that many people consider pineapple pizza disgusting, it's my favorite one. Okay, great. What do we think? Although, lots of people are saying, although. What about, so that's number one. What about number two? It's unconventional. Many find it delicious. What do you think we could have there for number two? Okay, Miranda's answered number one, even though some people adore pineapple on pizza. Though, number two, despite, even though, Julia says, despite, no, sorry, Julia says, even though it's unconventional. Okay, yes, nice, Julia. Even though it's unconventional. Deepthi says, despite the fact that it's unconventional. While it's unconventional. Okay, all good options here. More than one correct answer here. Luigi, despite the fact that it's unconventional. Yep, we can say that. Even if it's unconventional. Yep, that's also good, Manuel. Although, lots of people saying although. And what about number three? Reina also says much as and then while. Good. What about number three? What do you think there? The debates. Pineapple remains a popular topping choice. The debates. What do you think we could have there as number three? Natasha says, in spite of the debates. That's a good idea. Okay. You could put the number when you put your answer in the chat, so I know which one you're talking about. Despite the debates, Paula says, good. Yep. In spite of the debates, yes, that's good, Julia. Francesco, in spite of the debates, okay, all good answers here. And we've got some more. Number four. Traditionalists may disagree. Adventurous eaters enjoy its sweet and savory blend. What do you think for number four? Traditionalists may disagree. Adventurous eaters enjoy its sweet and savory blend. Paola says for number four, much as. That seems good to me. Yeah, much as traditionalists may disagree. Okay. What do you think for number four? Have we got any more ideas? Whereas traditionalists may disagree. Okay, yep, nice answer there. Even if I can see as well, much as. Okay, even though, while. Okay, so lots of possible answers there. For number four. And what about number five? Okay, so here we've got the whole paragraph. So while some adore pineapple on pizza, others detest it. Even though it's unconventional, many find it delicious. Despite the debates, pineapple remains a popular topping choice. Though traditionalists may disagree, adventurous eaters enjoy its sweet and savory blend. Even if you're hesitant, give it a chance. You might be surprised. Okay, so these are just, this is just an example of which conjunctions we could use. Lots of other good ones that I've seen that you've been using in the chat. Okay, we're going over time a little bit today, but we've got one last thing for you to do. And at the beginning, we talked about artificial intelligence, and we already saw some contrasting ideas. So let's see, artificial intelligence, the great debate. For many, AI is very exciting, but others worry about the implications. So write some sentences to talk about contrasting ideas about AI. And so here are some ideas to help you. So you could use some of these ideas if you like, or you can use your own ideas. Right at the beginning when we talked about this, there were lots of your own ideas. So here are just some. Makes tasks easier, processes vast amounts of data very quickly, repetitive tasks, increases productivity, helps diagnose diseases, replaces humans, unemployment, over-reliance, cybersecurity threats, data privacy, misinformation, fake news, ethical concerns. So the implications, so it means the things, the consequences, things that could happen as a result of this, okay? So some people find it very exciting, but other people are worried about the consequences. So those are the two contrasting ideas. So can you use, even though, in spite of the fact that, despite, much as, even if, can you use, while, whereas, some of the conjunctions that we've had today, can you use some of those to give me a couple of sentences about AI? Oh, Luigi, I must leave you. Thank you for the best class. Oh, thanks for joining in. I'm sorry we've gone over time today. It's been quite a long lesson, so thanks for staying with us. If you've got a few more minutes, we've just maybe got about 2 or 3 minutes. If any of you have got some sentences that you'd like to share, Raphael also has to go. Okay, nice to have you with us, Raphael. I hope you'll be joining us again soon. Okay, any sentences to give us some contrasting ideas? So even if it makes tasks easier, right, what could we contrast there? Okay, so some people worry about it even if. Despite the fact that AI makes tasks easy, lots of people avoid using it. Okay, so sounds like you quite like using maybe AI, ChatGPT, something like that. What do you think? Have we got any other contrasting ideas about it? Even though we develop technology, we would not get a high artificial in technology. Okay. I can see, although AI is very exciting, it may replace humans. Okay, so that's what an implication that lots of people worry about. Even though it makes tasks easy, AI can be a security threat. Okay, yes. Despite the fact that AI plays a crucial role in terms of advancing your education, it may contain some misinformation. That's what we would say there, Julia, misinformation. For many people, AI is something special, but for others, it's something anxious. It's something to be anxious about, I think we'd have to say there, Nicola. Okay, lots of good ideas, but we have gone really over time today, I'm afraid. So we'll be back again next week with another live lesson. So thank you for participating today. Thanks for all your comments. It's been really great to have you with us. I hope that it's been useful. And yeah, if you want more practice on this, then check on the Learn English website, where you'll find some more information and some exercises to practice. Okay, so we've got to go now. So thank you for joining me today. Okay, thanks to you. Thanks everybody for all of your comments. It's been really great to have you. Okay, lovely to see you all. And thanks for coming and see you again soon. Bye bye.